My iPod and my phone is empty.
BYOD is bring your own device, which allows students to bring the devices they already own and they already have at home and in their pocket and use them at school. The first reason we did it in the BYOD is because we wanted the students to feel comfortable on campus. We didn't want it to be a change when they walk on campus. We wanted it to be the same. We didn't want it to everybody to put their devices away. We didn't want it to be against the rules at school. We wanted the two worlds to mesh and not be different.
I think it's a great opportunity for us to teach students to be responsible digital citizens. And that's what I told the parents. And basically what it is that because students have the privilege of being able to bring their own devices to school to interact with different academic and also social aspects of it, but where in the same time there is their responsibility to make sure that they treat that technology and use it properly. And that's kind of what we've been pushing with the students, that you have the privilege of bringing it, but you need to make sure you're responsible users of that technology.
The students absolutely love it because they're getting to learn with something they already own and they use at home all of the time, and they're much more engaged in their learning in the classroom.
The school only has a limited amount of computers and different kinds of electronics, so I guess it makes it easier for your kids that don't have iPhones so that if the other kids do, they can use the computers and stuff.
I think it's awesome, and the reason why is because I think that the kids really buy into the activities that we present to them. The kids, they live and they learn through these devices, so we just need to go with the flow and work with the kids with the devices that they're bringing in.
The engagement with the students is the biggest thing. We really see the kids involved in their classroom and involved in their studies.
The technology just engages them. They're technologically students. I mean, that's just what they do at home. That's what they do all the time. So it's just great to see them interact with it in an academic type format.
Most of the teachers really like it. It was slow to get people to buy in at first. There was a lot of concerns that we had to address over the last 3 or 4 years. But the teachers who have adopted it and moved on are absolutely, you couldn't take it away from them. You know, that's something they want to continue with. And then that's spreading out across the rest of our campus.
If I worked at a school that didn't have BYOD, I think it absolutely would be a struggle for me. I think I would feel like I was taking steps backwards because right now my kids are so prepared when they come into the classroom with the lesson. I would have to do more explaining to the kids what we were doing rather than now with the blended environment. The kids come in already knowing what the expectations are for the lesson that day. So I think it would take away from instructional time.
I was in a class and they're looking up recipes online in our home ec room. Just looking it up online and using the technology, comparing different recipes from different websites. I mean, kids are using technology for the right ways instead of using it that we hear about so many times in the press where it's a negative thing.
Well, I use Edmodo as my primary source of getting information out to my students. So, they access Edmodo quite a bit. We use it for PowerPoints. We use it for uploading assignments that I can annotate and then give immediate feedback to the students.
I tell you, what's really been great is, one, interacting with Edmodo. I see a lot of students at lunch that are using that, asking questions about assignments, even in the evening, wanting to know about different activities in school. So it's a great communication tool. Also in the classroom, you see it where kids are using it. One of our teachers uses it for responders through Edmodo. Some teachers using it for other projects when it comes to submitting documents, creating Prezis. You see the kids bringing in their netbooks, their laptops, their tablets, and they're interacting with the teacher and with the lesson.
I wouldn't be worried about all the other things that people are concerned with, theft and different negatives that are issued with it, because we just haven't seen them. We addressed a lot of them when we first started it. We really thought it was going to be a big problem, and it has turned out to be not a problem at all.
I absolutely have not had any problems with theft. In fact, what's happened in the classroom is the students who don't have handheld devices, they have found ways to partner up with kids who do have the handheld devices. And when you see them in the classroom, they're actually sharing the device between themselves. And so today, as the kids were going through the PowerPoint, I was working with the kids who needed a little bit more scaffolding and guided instruction during the lesson. And the kids who are comfortable with the lesson and can move on were partnering with the other kids and going through the PowerPoint faster than I was going through it with the kids who needed a little bit more help.
I think parents appreciate the fact that we're taking technology and we're showing students how to use it properly, how to use it in an effective manner, and it's academic, not just social. And I think the parents are happy about that. And when we do have to call a parent because a student is not following the rules, they're right on board with us and understanding that they violated that privilege because they weren't being responsible users of that technology.